All star praises to your how, Barsham, your shine. Double on Australia's of Greatman Stone, our apostles of James Greatman Stone, and our gratitude and honors to the brothers of the Irish and the Bowers to teach the word of your how, Barsham, your shine, sincerity and in truth. I teach in name, I push out this doctrine in the right and correct way without any blemish, any lies, you know, without any wild imaginations to it, but the truth, raw and unedited and cut straight to the point. Saying we are prophesying the downfall of the society here. You know, we bring out all information with the Lord give, which is the truth, to the 12 tribes and the nation of Israel, and not only to the 12 tribes also, but to the heathen them, especially the so-called white man. ESP, to the Edomites them, these men, because according to the Bible, these men are Edomites, come out of the lineage of Esau, Abraham, Isaac, Esau, come down to the tribes them in Edom, merely so-called Amalekites, which are so-called Jews, which are these men, because these men actually run the world. So we out here as a prophet of the Heavenly Father come to rip down our lies and edify the elect, as the scriptures have said. See, because there's a lot of lies that get taught in the world. No, we actually have prophecies that get fulfilled daily also. Same like war, this pending war, World War III, we're in a World War III already. No war not start off with guns and bullets of fire. War start off basically from an economic standpoint. No, America already going on. Exactly. America already going on depression already from 2008, the housing bubble, which caused them economic to get suppressed so bad. Them they have to link them on a twin tower. Forget for going to the Middle East to destabilize some country. Forget them oil. Countries like Afghanistan, Iraq, same.
It still never stopped the collapse
2008. Because what happened is that the government actually bailed out the banks, which put the country in a more debt. See, countries like Libya was a threat to the American dollar. Because when Libya, what Gaddafi have in mind, was to leave the FRN, which is the Federal Reserve Note, which is the US dollar, and start trade oil, in trade things in gold. And by trading in gold, it had devalued the US dollar. See, because the reason why US dollar is at the point of is because they have the world reserve currency. Starting from World War II, they call it the petrol dollar. They buy petrol using the US dollar. Every country use use US dollar as world reserve currency. So, for example, when you people live in Jamaica, you go anywhere in the country like the United States, you go buy US dollars. That means when you go, you can use it at any other country where you go, any whatsoever country, because it is world reserve currency. No, America in a $17.8 trillion worth of debt, soon to be $18.8 trillion worth of debt, and still climbing. The reason why the American dollar still have any form of value is because nations like China, Russia have American bonds. And also people have confidence in the US dollar because people still are trading it. So when you have Libya, countries like Libya are step away from the American dollar, and the BRICS nations like Brazil, Russia, India, China, and South America and South Africa step away from the US dollar. Basically, it's a cost, a threat to the US dollar. It's get weakened because these nations already say, yo, the American dollar, they really make no sense, because we pump more money in the economy without resources for bucket. Them call it fractional reserve. Fractional reserve banking. See, them just pump money in the US economy without any form of gold, any form of substance.
We we'll print more money out of thin air, which are weakening the dollar. So these countries actually, as you say, oh, them bonds that they have in America, it will get devaluated daily. So you got people who are selling out the bonds them from America, which will cause America to go into more debt. So America is a greater threat right now in which them have to fight this world war to come out of this this depression. The only way America can come out of this depression is to fight what? World War III, in which I'm going to cause them to be totally annihilated. We have a scripture.
Okay.
Yeah. Hold on. Oh, yeah, bring it up.
Ezekiel chapter 38, verse 4. And I will turn thee back and put hooks in thy jaws.
Right, because over the years you have Gog, which is Russia, actually I try to sign some peace treaties with America. But the Lord himself said, look here, may I put hooks in your jaw and may I turn you back. Turn you back from being friends with America. Go ahead.
And I will bring thee forth and all thine armies and all thine army horses and horsemen.
Right.
All of them clothed all sorts of armor.
Go ahead.
Even a great company with bucklers and shields.
Right, so the Lord basically prepared this war. The Lord actually get Russia ready. The Lord actually get Russia ready for this war. Because believe it or not, Russia are going to nuke America. Russia alongside with other countries like Iran, the EU, China actually are going to nuke America. America get burned by thermonuclear fire.
Right.
Go ahead.
And all of them handling swords.
Right?
Persia. Ethiopia.
Who is Persia? Who is Persia? If you go back in your history, you know that Persia is Iran. So the scripture has people, Iran. These are the swords that I'm handling. Rockets and missiles. Go ahead.
Ethiopia. Libya.
Right, like Libya where America destabilized. Go ahead.
Libya with them, all of them with shield and helmet, Gomer and all his band. The house of Togomar,
right,
of the North Quarters,
right,
and all his bands, and many people with thee.
Right, so basically the Lord of Russia as this upcoming power, where all these nations actually are looked to. Because even Venezuela, they don't look to Russia. Cuba, look to Russia. Brazil, I look to Russia. You actually have Germany. Germany actually, I look to Russia. All them allies of America, majority of them actually, I look to Russia for help, for defense. These nations actually know that America is nothing but a lie and thief. Like the example, Germany said, look here, we need back with gold from America. America can't produce back Germany gold. Why? The elites have already rub up that gold. The elites have robbed that. So you have Germany now stand afar off and pray America like a fussy. Venezuela asked them for them gold when Hugo Chavez was alive. They not get it back. So all these nations basically are pre-America for destroy America. What America have to offer to them is democracy. Democracy is nothing but confusion. And through peace, America going into the Middle East will destroy the people of their country. Like Iraq, for example. America go down and use depleted uranium on the people. They have babies about with them intestine outside. 5 head, 20 feet, 6 hands. Some deformed things. Because of America. So all them nations here are looking at America and wait for the time to destroy America. Because America is Mr. Babylon, which is spiritually known as Sodom and Egypt. Thus said the scriptures. And your loved ones are there, when they're in America, will get burned. And if you're going to America, you're not part of the elect also, will now get burned.
Right.
If, that's if you make it through the martial law. Go ahead.
Revelation chapter 17, verse 16. And the 10 horns which thou sawest, right, upon the beast
What
these shall eat the